Yeah, he's getting really big. And today, we move him. But where?
Well, for the first time in a long time,
we're gonna have fish tanks in the house again.
You guys might remember, I built this entire false wall, created this brick out of styrofoam. I showed you guys how to do it. He's coming over here. Very similar to what he just had, a few rocks and that same piece of wood that you guys seen earlier. Same size tank, same filtration, same everything. However, it's just going to be eye level. Having such a beautiful, unique, and stunning fish on the floor, it's a tough pill to swallow.
Plus, when we built this, we were coming up with like ideas and cool fish that we could add to it, and there's nothing cooler than an electric eel. Like, who has one of those? But we have other reasons why we need to move him. Simply put, I'm moving every tank along this wall. That wall is 23 feet long. I've already kind of started to like disassemble the tanks. Well, you guys know by now, I'm building a 21 foot long aquarium. I've even started buying all the fish for it.
Not only do I need his aquarium and the gallery is kind of changing and evolving, wouldn't it be a lot easier to appreciate such a beautiful and majestic fish while standing there looking at it as opposed to squatting down? The other problem with this is simple. Luke, can you come here, buddy? Lukey, come here, bub. You can come.
Oh, you can't get past this, of course.
Can you come here for a second? Luke has the tendency to put his paws up here. Now watch this. That is an aggressive electric eel. What you're seeing on camera this entire time is how he acts all of the time. We, of course, can't move him to the aquarium to a fresh tank. So I drained one of his canister filters of all of its biological media. I put the majority of it in this 3-gallon bucket. So when we transfer him over, he'll start off with some already cycled beneficial bacteria. But I'm worried he's not gonna eat right away. So we're gonna have to feed him first. They say don't feed your fish as soon as you get it or as soon as you move it or right before you move it. And I bet you don't go swimming 30 minutes after you ate. I've never actually had any issues feeding a fish before I move them and or as soon as I get them. In fact, it's always better to make sure they have a packed belly rather than not, unless you have to ship them long distances. Because the fact of the matter is this, what if he doesn't eat when we move him to his new tank? What if he needs a couple of, or even a week or two to settle in? Damn, at least he's got a full belly. Look how wild this guy is. Look how thick he is. Absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous, beautiful animal. Stunning. When I was at Predatory Fins, I gotta say, I damn near picked up a couple of their smaller electric eels, which were about a foot long. Maybe someday, but I'm definitely gonna need a bigger tank. Probably 240, 375. At least these fish are in the care of somebody that will definitely build them a tank. Now, how are we going to move them?
Well, I've enlisted the help of my son, Darius. I'm going to net him in this extra large plastic, fiberglass maybe, rubber net. And as soon as I get him, my son, hopefully faster than that when the time comes, is going to toss this towel over him. Then we're just gonna run him to the house. Luckily, the eel can breathe oxygen. Mind you, we're in Canada. It is November. What about the cold weather? That's what the towel is for. The towel is also gonna prevent him from kind of jumping out. He's gonna be splashing around. I've already timed it. It's a 20-second walk into the basement. Why not put him in a bucket or a Rubbermaid tote? You mean net him, put him in a tote, bring him in the house, net him, bring him in a tote. I just think that's a little bit more stressful. But that's up for debate, and that's where you guys are gonna have to take over in the comment section below. Did Joey move him right? And he's gonna survive and he's gonna be fine. Otherwise, you wouldn't see this video, right? But could I have done it better? And if so, I need reasons backed with like facts and or information. You guys know what to do.
Okay, so a handful of food for him. And Luke, you can't have this. You don't even like seafood. But the rest, excuse me, Tamara. I can't even believe you're out here. As beautiful you are and as messy in a place as this is right now.
We've got to feed something else the rest of this.
Quick bite for these guys. I fed them earlier, so I don't even know if they're gonna eat. We'll see. Yeah. Bunch of savages. These guys are getting big. Real big. It's really difficult to put these guys in perspective because as I look at the camera, as I look at your point of view, I see a bunch of like little tiny fish. But these guys are the size of a hand each. And for the little guys, maybe aquarium talk TV size hand.
Upper
but for
decky.
The rest of them,
upper
like
decky.
Normal size hands. They're not too aggressive. Like I said, they just ate. Suppose we can give some to the 2000.
I'll give it all to them. Everybody's already eaten. I should have just defrosted enough just for the electric eel, but...
Yeah, it's always fun to feed everybody again. Look at the Nicaraguans in there. We gotta add the waru in there, the panda waru, shortly. I'm likely gonna add them tonight. We'll see how that goes. But there's a lot of big fish in here. But if the Nicaraguans can do well, from Central America, and the rest are almost... All the cichlids are almost, well, besides the parrots, are from South America. Technically, they all speak a different language. But everybody in here seems to be mostly docile. I think they'll do really well. 2,000 gallons, huge tank, they should do fine. I don't see why not. Seems like there's no fish in here right now. There's some are. There you are.
To be fair, we're both nervous. We have to move the world's most dangerous fish, at least the most shocking, from one aquarium to another in a totally different area. I'm depending on my son to make sure everything works right. Here's the game plan. This is perfect world scenario. I'm going to net him, and he's just gonna lay there nicely. I'm gonna say, Darius, net over it, blanket over it, and then Darius is going to open up all the doors, he's going to guide us through it, and you guys are going to follow us. Let's see if that works. Now, to net him without him jumping, I don't know if he can shock through, I don't even know what this is made out of, but he got in! Did you see that? Did you see that he got in? Okay. We have, from here to here is probably 6 inches, so I don't know how he's gonna feel. One of the things I like to do is grab the net so they don't bang onto the trim or anything like that, but you ready, Darius?
Yeah.
This is an electric eel. He's 3 feet long.
No pressure.
I am the professional, but I am scared. He's a big boy. Ready?
Yep.
Let's go. Fix it. Fix it in the front. Watch him. Don't let him touch you. Let's go. Door. Pause for... No. We're going in the basement door. Darius. Oh, we didn't go over this. Keep it moving. I'm sorry, son. I'm sorry. Go! Okay. Oh, he. Okay, towel. Okay. This could be a lot worse. Oh, damn. How am I gonna get him up there? Push him. No, I'm not gonna push him. It's an electric eel!
Just flick him in.
One thing that I know. Turn around and look at all the other decorations I got you, bro. Watch your head. So he's surrounded now. We need to get his lids. We gotta make sure he doesn't jump. Darius, go on top of the aquarium and pull off the lids. I'm going to start switching out the filtration.
Where do you want me to go?
Stay with me. So. I fed him for a number of reasons. Make sure he eats while he's in there, but while we transition fish, a lot of the times when we only switch out the filtration, he's basically in purified water. There are no There is no ammonia, fish waste, pee, nothing like that. So over the next couple of days, he's going to produce that ammonia. He's going to feed this bacteria, because within 24 hours, almost all of the beneficial bacteria on this is going to be dead.
And that bees, right?
Yeah. So open that up. Tamara, you want to follow him along? And use the stool beside you and cover him up. Now, there are cutouts, and we're going to try to layer them on top of the glass. Now, son, I know that you only have a year and a half left of school, but for the love of sweet baby Jesus, will you please be the next king of DIY? You can start as the prince. I'll teach you how to do everything. But, bro, let's be fair. I'm getting old.
True.
True? Fake news. Okay. So, these Eheim filters come with a tremendous amount of biological media. Like, properly sized. That's always been one thing I really like about them. I'm gonna pour the water out. Mechanical filtration. Eheim, do you pay me? No, you do not. Eheim, do you make great products? Yes, you do. This is Eheim's notification to pay me. Darius, you want to go get me, like a pot? Like a big pot? Not to piss in, because I don't have one of them. Not a frying pan. God. So they do come with this type of stuff, but if you can replace it with some sort of ceramic media, far superior. I throw that stuff out. Oh, and this is also another part of my house that I'm almost done. I just need a few more days. You can look up. I just need a couple more days. Tamara, two, three more days, I'll finish everything. I always start these freaking projects. I get these big, bright ideas. I always got an idea. If you guys think I switch my aquariums around, I can assure you, living with me is much more hectic. I want to build everything all of the time. I love it. It just allows me to escape reality. Because of course I am delusional. Yeah, that'll do some. Feel free to use them if you do not already have cycled media. For me, brace yourself. I'm probably going to throw them out. Only because I don't have a use.
My brand new pot.
Oh, is that one of your brand new pots? Oh, you did get the brand new pots?
I just got one.
I'm always like, can I get this fish? Can I get this other piece of material? Can I get this fish food? Can I get some North Fin? And you're like, yes. Can I get this pot?
Not like that, though.
It's usually like that. I think I'm going to save these bigger balls.
Okay.
These are, they don't come this size. They're, I forget the brand, Marine Pure. And they get them in bigger balls, but they eventually wear down. But these are 6 years old. When I hook this filter up, do you see what's happening right there? That's mulm. So that's beneficial bacteria. That is broken down fish waste. Mulm, at one point, M-U-L-M, used to cost the same as gold. Nowadays, people are adding chemicals to their aquariums. This is a massive amount of surface area for one fish. Mind you, of course, he's gonna get bigger. And badder. And more electrified in due time. But I will say that my son said he would touch him.
Allegedly.
Oh, yeah. Oh, just give me a second. Oh, that is cool. I arguably have the most active electric eel of all time. Interesting. A lot of things are going to be electric down here. Not only do we have an electric eel, but I'll be doing a little bit of training down here to put on one of the most electrified events the aquarium hobby has ever witnessed. I'd like to say a few, I think that we should actually have just a few moments of silence for Rod from Predatory Fins. I'm just thinking in advance. That's enough. Do you guys want to know a side story? It's on my channel. It's the Eheim Professional 3, something like that. Eheim sent me a free filter. They were sponsoring my channel, just sending me free stuff, and I never got a penny from them. But the reason I worked with them and the reason I did it for free was a simple reason. The president of Eheim North America said, look, we don't need you to say anything negative about Fluval, but if you do, that's a bonus. And I thought that was funny because, like, even back then, like, drama was fun. I'll probably cut that out. Because I use a lot of Fluval stuff.
Yeah.
Upon putting on that filter, we're going to get a tremendous amount of that mulm pumped throughout the aquarium. I don't care. It's going to settle. It's going to seed. The sand, it's going to be fine. It's absolutely harmless to the electric eel. Why, do you ask? And you might not have. It doesn't matter that it's not in your aquarium. It's still within the system. It's still in the filtration. Just because you don't see it doesn't mean it's not within the system. It's still in the filter. It's still being cycled through it. All the water, all that beautiful clean water is being pumped through that mulm, through that beneficial bacteria, and pumped right back to the aquarium. Just because you can't see it doesn't mean it's not within your filtration system. Your number one point of defense with having a healthy aquarium is, of course, your mechanical filtration. Clean it more often than you are. Now, we see if I was right. The wood is from the old aquarium. The sand is identical. He did not have a 3D background, but I placed the rocks strategically so he can still get around them without knocking them over. Electric eels are not a boisterous fish. They're sending out continuous electrical signals. Discovering their tank, he just came up to the top to get a breath. But now, every single day, I get to enjoy the electrical eel besides looking on the floor, squatting down, hoping Luke doesn't jump on it. Plus, we freed up a 180. Now we move one step closer to that 21-foot aquarium. And if you want to see that, you're not subscribed to this channel yet, come here, son. And if you don't want to see me put him up for adoption,
what?
Make sure you subscribe to the channel now before, I don't know, you become one of those kids that donate $1 today and...
No. You got to do it.
But if you don't want me to see you put him up for adoption, make sure you're subscribed, or I become worse by the minute. Make sure you like the video too. Oh, like, and oh, check out the links in my bio. They get more exciting by the moment, by the minute. They're my favorite. It's all my links. It's called, and then click it, and then just read it. Sometimes there's something extra, but it's only there for a few hours, but then it disappears. Anyways, leave me alone.